Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Dave, is that you? If you're new here, my name's Ash, I'm 27, I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast, and on this channel we play Capture the Flags and we learn cybersecurity together as we go on becoming a professional in the community. On today's video, we are going over DAV, DAV, Dave. For my notes on this room and all the others, check Hack Notes in the description, and while you're in the description, you can find links and timestamps to anything mentioned in this video. With that all being said, let's go ahead and get started. Alrighty, we are trying Hack Me like usual. Same with our other boot to root machines that we've been doing. We don't have much information, so we can go ahead and just click start machine. Great, so once we have our IP, make sure we're on the network and we can indeed see the box. So we'll go ahead and do a Rust scan like we usually do. Great, we see a port 80. So we'll go ahead and navigate over there. And it looks like it's just a default Apache 2 web page. And after a quick scroll through our view source, we don't see any leftover comments or hints. So it looks like there's nothing here for us. So we'll go back to our Rust scan and we'll see if we can do some further enumeration on this port 80, given that it's the only one that we can actually see. While that's running, let's go ahead and start up a Ferox Buster scan and using our discovery web content common.txt word list. And flicking back to our further enumeration, we can see an Apache 2.4.18 that's running. So maybe there is an exploit or a well-known vulnerability that we can go ahead and look up. Otherwise, our points of interest that we can find is there is a 401 for a web dev, given that our room name is called DAV. This is looking like the way that we're going to be going. So let's go ahead and click that and see what we get. So we're greeted with some sort of HTTP authentication. So we click cancel. We don't have any leaks of how to log in or where to log in. All we can really do is refresh and try again. So we can try some basic admin password, admin, and we're not going to really get anywhere. So if we just do some further research and we just Google web DAV, turns out that it's a set of extensions to the hypertext transfer protocol. And if we go one step further and we look up our default credentials, we do see here that there's jigsaw, which doesn't actually work. But we also have a page on HackTrix, which is a popular repository for all things hacking. And from quickly looking through, I don't see any default credentials. So I've hopped over to another blog post that I found. And we can see here that we do actually have a user and password. Let's go ahead and try these. And that grants us access. So we have a password.dav file. So if we click on that, we can actually see it. And it looks like we've got the user that we've just logged in as, and then a hash for a password. So we can go ahead and we can copy this. So I'm gonna run hash ID against it, and that's probably gonna error. We need to put in quotes so that it recognizes what we've got. So it thinks that it's an MD5R or an Apache MD5. Given that we had $ and we have APR, I'm thinking that it definitely could be this MD5 APR, and it also might be this. So we have a little bit of testing to try and find out. We go look up hashcat examples. This is going to be what we're going to use to try and crack this hash. So we just need to find the right mode. So let's just start with the control F and look at MD5. So we have the normal MD5s. We have ones that are used for WordPress. But if we scroll down, we have the mode 1600, which is for Apache. And if we actually look at the example that it's given, $APR, we can actually confirm again by looking back at our hash. So it looks like 1600 is going to be the mode that we're after. So we'll run hashcat, we'll do a dash lowercase m to specify the mode. And since we've just found it, we'll try 1600. I guess before we go any further though, we should just echo this and pipe it into a hash.txt. Then all we need to do is pass through that and then the word list. So for these easy boxes, we usually can rely on the fact that we're using a RockYou word list. So after a little time, this isn't providing any results. So if we actually go back to our research that we did, we saw that there is a tool that we can use, Cadaver. And this was actually mentioned in HackTrix 2. So let's go ahead and try and get something with that. So this should be installed in our rolling version of Kali. So we can just go ahead and run it against the directory that we have. And in this case, it is our web dev. So since we do have a login, we can go ahead and try that. These are the default credentials that we saw earlier. And interestingly enough, we actually do get some sort of shell access. So we see our password file that we saw earlier that we're we're trying to crack. If we look up the help menu, we can actually do a few interesting things. We just used our ls just out of habit, but there's actually a command called put. So we can actually go and use a program like RevShells to generate our reverse shell. And we can go ahead and make sure that we're using our local IP to our machine so we can connect back to it and then whatever port that we want to. So that's what we're going to be using as our listener. So we can go ahead and use the PHP pen test monkey. So we'll scroll down and we'll click copy. Go ahead and make a new shell.php. We'll paste that in and we'll just double check that we have our correct IP and listening port. We'll save this off. We'll go back and we'll say put shell.php, and we can see here that that's looking in our current directory, and that's exactly where I put this shell.php. So since there was a matching file name, it's gone ahead and put that into the web dev directory. So now all we have to do to actually activate that is to go shell.php. I guess just before we actually do that, we want to actually set up a netcat listener. Right. Now that we have that listening, we can go ahead and select enter on our shell.php to activate it, and we can go back to our listener, which it's contacted back to. So now we actually have user access. So before we go any further and we start looking around, let's go and elevate our shell. So for this, we can go ahead and use Python. We'll go Control Z. We'll go ahead and paste that in, last export, and then we have an elevated shell. So we can actually use some nice. So first, let's go ahead and look in our home directory. So in there, we have another HTML directory where we have the index.html that we saw, and then this directory of web dev. And in there, we have the password that we saw earlier and the shell.php. And if you're interested, going back to our hashcat, we ended up actually exhausting the files, so there was no luck with trying to crack that. But that's okay, because we've already got access another way. So there's nothing else that we can see in here. So let's head over to the home directory, and we can see here that we've found another user. We just go ls star, we can find that the user.txt is indeed in the Merlin directory. So we can go ahead and cat that out, and we can paste it into TryHackMe, and there is our user.txt. Great, so after we've found that, we can go ahead and run sudo dash l to see what we can run as the root user. So we can actually use the cat concatenate, so we can actually see any file that we want. We can concatenate any file, which is kind of cool. So some important files that we can go ahead and cat then, it's like the Etsy shadow. So we can actually go ahead and find the hashes for like Merlin. Whereas if we cat out the Etsy password, we're not gonna actually see those hashes. But like other typical CTFs like this in the boot to root category, we usually know that there's a root.txt in the root folder. So we go ahead and just list out what's in the root. We have a permission denied, but we have a pretty good idea what we're looking for, because typically we have a root folder, and in that folder or directory, we have that root.txt. So unfortunately that's denied too. But since we do have sudo permissions, if we just run sudo cat, then we actually go ahead and get the flag. So we can go ahead and copy that, paste it into TryHackMe, and there we are. We have successfully rooted the machine and we've got root access. Awesome. So thank you so much for watching up until this part of the video. I appreciate it. Feel free to do all the YouTube-y stuff like always, like, comment, subscribe. Up on the screen, you're going to see the recommended video for Library, which was the last walkthrough that was posted. So go ahead, enjoy that, which is continuing on the boot to root saga. And this is probably going to be the last boot to root for a while. So I hope you've enjoyed the last few rooms as much as I have. All right. Thanks again, guys. And I will catch you in the next one.